Good morning, Good Life Kids. It's so good to be with you guys today. Let's stand up and worship together.
And now, a special report from Hunt Burkleton.
Trismus! Am I saying that right? Trismus? Trismus, a virtually unknown holiday that is celebrated nearly 25 times a year. This holiday is set apart as a celebration of a savior. But who is this savior? I'm here at Mooseberry Academy, school for the very, very, very gifted students. If they can't help unpack this mystery, no one can. I'm investigative reporter Hunt Burkleton, and this is Hunt Burkleton Knows What's Really Going On with Trismus. Is Trismus a celebration of a savior over sin?
Trismus isn't a thing. Christmas is.
Yes, it is a celebration of our savior who saved us from sin.
And this sin is a bad thing? That's what everyone keeps telling me.
No comment. Who let you in here?
Yeah, sin is bad. It's worse than a fire-breathing bear, or mosquitoes, or fire-breathing mosquitoes, or mosquito-breathing bears, or...
So if this sin is as bad as the experts say it is, what kind of savior does it take to eliminate it? And how?
This savior was most definitely a stuntsman, because he would be facing many dangers. Kablammo.
Kablammo, indeed.
Some of your facts are off. Allow me to clarify. We don't celebrate Christmas 25 times a year. The actual holiday is only one day a year. But hopefully we hold the meaning in our hearts all year long.
And for viewers out there who don't know what it means to hold something in your heart, it's the same as holding your breath, like this.
Not bad. I once held my breath for 16 minutes straight. I don't remember anything after minute two. And I woke up in the hospital. But kablammo!
That's not what that means at all. To hold something in your heart means to remember its meaning or purpose.
Does this purpose have anything to do with bears?
No, nothing to do with bears. I honestly don't know why bears keeps coming up.
I feel partly responsible for the bear thing. They're very scary.
Christmas is special because of a savior who saved us. But he could only save us because he was special. His name is Jesus. Before Jesus was born, sin separated us from God. You see, God is so perfect, he can't be anywhere near sin. That's where Jesus comes in. He took our sin.
Jesus can take our sin. But what makes Jesus so special? How could he save everyone from sin? Could it be he is a superhero?
Yes, Jesus is a superhero.
Hold on. Jesus never wore a cape or costume. He's actually beyond a superhero. He's God's son, which makes him God too.
Some people knew even before he was born. This was all part of God's plan. He sent angels ahead of time to tell certain people the good news. Remember, this was God's plan from the beginning. So, he was giving humans clues and hints through prophets and angels for thousands of years. The Savior had been promised for a long time.
This promised Savior had a lot to live up to. Join me next time as I dig deeper into the question, who is this Savior that we celebrate at Christmas?
Christmas!
Until next time, I'm Hunt Berkleton, and I know what's really going on!
Christmas is my most favorite time of year. I love the lights, I love Christmas trees, I love spending extra time with my family. Most of all, I love it because it is a special time to remember all the blessings that God has shared, and to be thankful for Jesus being born to Mary and Joseph. Jesus lived a sinless life and then took on all of our sin so that we could have a relationship with God. What an amazing, incredible thing. John 3:17 says, God did not send his son to the world to condemn its people. He sent him to save them. Now let's watch our Bible video. Today we're going to learn a little more about Mary and Joseph.
One day, God sent an angel, Gabriel, to visit a young virgin named Mary. She was engaged to be married to Joseph. The angel told Mary, "Rejoice! You have found favor with God. He is with you." Mary was confused and wondered what the angel had meant. I mean, it is a bit of a vague statement. Gabriel said, "Do not be afraid, Mary. God has chosen you to be the mother of a special baby boy. He will be named Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. His kingdom will never end." Mary asked, "How can this happen? I'm not even married yet." That sounds like a reasonable question. Fortunately, the angel answered and told her, "The Holy Spirit will make it possible. The child will be the Son of God." Then the angel told Mary, "Nothing is impossible with God. Even your relative, Elizabeth, is going to have a baby." Mary said, "I understand. I will do what God wants me to do." When Joseph found out Mary was going to have a baby, he decided to secretly break his engagement to her. Soon after, the angel appeared to him in a dream. The angel said, "Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife. Mary's baby is from the Holy Spirit. Name the baby Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." This is how God's promise to the prophet Isaiah about the Savior will happen. Jesus will be Emmanuel, God with us. When Joseph awoke, he did just as the angel said. Joseph and Mary were married.
What a blessing God gave Mary and Joseph. Mary and Joseph were so brave and listened to God's instructions. I'm sure they were a bit confused and scared, but they listened to God's angel and were great parents to Jesus. This was all part of God's plan. God had told people many years earlier that an unmarried woman would have a son. Jesus lived his life exactly how God wanted human beings to live. He lived a sinless, perfect life, and then he willingly took our place at the cross and took our punishment so that we could all have a right relationship with God. People talk a lot about gifts about Christmas time, but I can't think of a gift more special or precious as Jesus. Now let's bow our heads as we pray. Dear God, thank you for your perfect plan. Thank you for sending Jesus to be our Savior. Help us this week to tell everyone we know about this awesome, amazing gift. Amen. Okay, before we end our time with one more worship song, I want to remind you all that you can download the coloring pages and activity sheets and everything from our website. See you guys later.
Count on one thing, the same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. And yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name. Oh, yes, I will sing for joy when my heart is heavy all my days. Oh, yes, I will. Fail me now, you won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out.